Aloha and welcome. Happy New Year. 2022. 2021 was way too fast, but I guess that's all in the divine scope of things. Welcome to 2022. Amazing things happening this year. I've seen the previews. It's going to be awesome. In celebration of 2022, I would really like to invite you into a feeling of acceptance. I know that oftentimes I like to do the, I'm going to change things and make resolutions and do all of that, which oftentimes for me goes by the wayside in an hour or two, sometimes a little longer. So this year I was thinking about that. I'm going, you know, I think for this one, I'm going to just cultivate an attitude of acceptance. Acceptance of what I am, who I am, how I move through the world. Not saying I can't change if I find something in there, but not with the intention of walking into this year trying to change. And with an attitude of acceptance for what is, because I'm sure there's a divine plan someplace. I'm equally sure I can't see it, which could be a good thing. But here we are. So as we drop into the intention for this first gong journey of 2022, invite you to set the intention. And it can be what you want, but I'm throwing out acceptance because that feels right to me. I'm totally thrilled with Seth's offering from last week. If you missed it, go to YouTube. It's there. Around heart-brain cohesion through breath. And so if that thrills you, the quick outline version is that you put your hand on your heart because your attention and energy will flow where you put your hands. You breathe with awareness around your heart, and you can choose one or all four, I guess it depends on how long you got, to cultivate a feeling, like a real feeling state of care, appreciation. What is it?
Compassion
and gratitude. So one or all of those, or a combination of them, breathing into your heart will change your day in 5 minutes. I can attest to this, and that's an invitation I'll probably extend a few more times as we do these, because it's incredibly powerful and beautiful. So here we go. Heart cohesion, acceptance. We're going to do this for about an hour, maybe a little bit longer. It's going to get loud and soft, loud and soft, loud and soft. I'm going to play that. It's going to get very quiet for a couple minutes, maybe three, and then I'll talk you back. In the quiet times, as we're starting up and as we're coming out, the invitation is to just scan through your body. An invitation, like all the other things I've asked you or offered for you to do. But for me, sometimes it's useful to just scan through my body. Find if there's any tension any place, note where that might be, and then at the end to scan again and see if there's a difference. I know for me there always is. My queen always has a difference. And I make up that a lot of you do too. Okay, we're gonna honey honey. We're gonna breathe three breaths together, please. While we do that, deep into the belly, completely and slowly filled up all the way, hold for a couple of seconds, just as easily and slowly release. When you're down, I like to pull my belly towards my spine, hold that for a couple of seconds. That's a complete breath cycle. We do that three times, and while we're doing that, we like to grow roots. And the roots that I'm growing into Mama Gaia, some that go deep, deep, and some that spread out, will join with your roots who are in this room. And thank you so much for coming out in the weather. And it will also, I believe, in a quantum field, will grow roots and interconnect with yours. So we are creating a quantum field of evolution right here now, Jack. Oh boy. Here we go. See you in an hour. Thank you. Thank you.
As this sound draws to a close, and the last of the vibrations waft off into the ethers, the invitation is to find your breath. Allow it to guide you home. back into this present space, time continuing. These seconds go by, 1 second at a time. As you find yourself dropping back into here and now, the invitation is to remember that attitude of acceptance, that space where everything is okay, just the way it is. Even if you don't understand why. Even if it looks maybe just a little bit cray cray. As that acceptance takes a hold of your spirit and energy like wildfire, you may find that your fingers and toes get a little happy and just need to live it. I encourage you to let that happen. Just slowly let that waking up of your body do its thing. It's a good time to notice what we talked about at the beginning. If there's any sense of change in your physical or emotional body. As compared to an hour ago. Really important to drink water a little bit more than normal over the next 2-3 days. She said this heavy metal moves some energy, and sometimes that releases toxins, things that have been built up for some time. And if you give your body adequate water, good clean water, goes a long way towards helping it help itself by flushing those things that it may not need.
Hey, sister.
Sorry, I'm drinking water.
There you go. Drink water. We're going to let the FaceTime and YouTube audience go. Thank you so much. Have an awesome 2022. If you're not seeing this until 2042, I hope it's been a great 20 years. We're here every Saturday. If it's 20 years from now, it may not be in the foreseeable future. We look forward to seeing you live Hawaii Standard Time. We start the stream at 8:15. Oh my God, that was like a rhyme, dude.
Blessings.
Aloha.
Aloha. Aloha.